His name was Norvell, and he was born in Harlem. By his late teens, he was a popular stage singer and manager of his town's first movie theater. In 1925, he starred as the Tin Man in the silent film The Wizard of Oz. Today, he is known as a classic American comic actor and half of one of Hollywood's greatest comedy teams of all time, Laurel and Hardy. This world-famous duo began in the era of silent films and lasted from 1927 to 1951. Introducing Oliver Hardy, next on Markin History. This is the historical marker for Oliver Norvell Hardy, located here in Harlem, Georgia. You can find this marker at the Laurel and Hardy Museum in downtown Harlem. Every year, on the first Saturday in October, tens of thousands of loyal fans come to Harlem, Georgia, from around the world to share in the memories at the Laurel and Hardy Festival. Norvell was born in Harlem, Georgia, on January 18, 1892, to parents Oliver and Emily Hardy. He was the youngest of five children. Sadly, his father died that same year in November. In 1903, his mother moved the Hardy family to Georgia's former capital of Milledgeville so she could manage the Baldwin Hotel. As you can imagine, Norvell was constantly bullied and teased about his weight growing up, but he was able to compensate by sharing his wonderful singing voice with his local audiences. Norvell Hardy had been preordained for a military career like his father, but destiny stepped in after he became manager and projectionist at the Palace Movie Theater in Milledgeville, Georgia in 1910. It is possible that Norvell found inspiration after viewing the films of John Bunny, the world-famous fat man of the day and the first comedian of the motion picture era. Norvell soon became obsessed with the new film industry and was convinced that he could do a better job than the actors that he viewed up on that silver screen. A friend suggested that he move to Jacksonville, Florida, where some of the films were being made. So Norvell changed his first name to Oliver in honor of his dad and moved to Jacksonville in 1913 to follow his acting dreams. Oliver was a big man, weighing 300 pounds at 6'1" tall. Restricted by his size when it came to casting, he was almost always the big villain or the clumsy fella in the films for the Lubin Manufacturing Company. His first film was called Outwitting Dad, produced in 1914. By the end of that year, Oliver had made 39 short films, billed as Babe Hardy. Because of his weight, his height, and his menace face, Oliver became the heavy in many silent films during his time on the East Coast. In 1917, Hardy moved to Hollywood. As a freelance actor, Hardy worked for several Hollywood studios, including Sunlight Pictures, who released a two-reel comedy called The Lucky Dog in 1921. In a magical moment captured on film, this was the first time that Oliver Hardy played opposite an English actor who would become his lifelong friend and partner. Though they appeared in scenes together, Oliver Hardy and Stan Laurel played independently of each other and not as the comedic team they were later to become. Of course, Oliver played the heavy again. As you can see from this clip from the film, Stan's eyes looked kind of funny. It was discovered that his pale blue eyes showed up as white on orthochromatic film of the time. Film producers tried to fix the problem with eye makeup, but it wasn't well received. Stan Laurel had to step behind the camera, working as a gag man and a director at Hal Roach Studios, home of the R-Gang series. Meanwhile, Babe made appearances with the Little Rascals. Later, panchromatic film was developed and Laurel began acting in front of the camera again. Hal Roach saw comic potential between Stan Laurel and Oliver Hardy, so he put them together as a double act in their first short called Putting Pants on Philip in 1927. The results are hilarious. So began a long career for the best-loved comic duo in American cinema history. By the way, Oliver picked this film as his favorite comedy short. It is interesting to note that Stan Laurel was a big part of their behind-the-scenes success, helping craft the team's slapstick films and writing and directing some of their best material. In another Hal Roach silent film shot that year, Battle of the Century had one of the greatest pie fights ever filmed. Guess who gets the first pie in the face? Yep, it was Ollie. Of course, it escalates soon after. Over 3,000 cream pies died in the making of this movie, which were thrown not with abandon, but with slow burn precision, heightening the comedic effect.
Don't be rude.
Oliver Hardy developed many mannerisms as his career grew. Of course, there was the tie twiddle and the finger waving, but his signature gag was breaking the fourth wall, as they say in the theater. In order to break the fourth wall, the character communicates directly with the audience. Oliver Hardy often broke the fourth wall in his films with Stan Laurel, where he would stare directly at the lens. It was his way of connecting with the audience through the camera. His close-up glares often showed disbelief over his fate while looking for sympathy. He also stared at the camera during one of his famous and hilarious slow burns. During the course of their career, the duo appeared as a team in 106 films, starring in 34 short silent films, 45 short sound films, and 27 full-length feature films. It never gets old. Their comedic genius was finally acknowledged with the 1932 Academy Award for Best Live Action Short Subject with their film, The Music Box. The simple plot revolved around the pair lugging a piano up a seemingly endless flight of steps before, eventually, it smashed to smithereens. The next year, Laurel and Hardy starred in the now famous feature film, The Sons of the Desert. The 1933 film begins with a group of men in fezes singing Auld Lang Syne. It is a California meeting of the Sons of the Desert, a fraternal lodge of which both Stan Laurel and Oliver Hardy are members.
I repeat, this, the oldest lodge in the great order of the Sons of the Desert, must be represented 100% in our annual convention at Chicago next week.
So what does Ollie's wife say?
You're not going.
Stan is reluctant to ask for fear that his wife Betty won't allow the trip, but decides to sneak away after Ollie persuades him. I guess what happens in Chicago doesn't stay in Chicago. Predictably, they pay the price for deceiving their wives.
I've got my gun, and I've never missed yet.
During their shenanigans, Ollie gives the famous movie quote,
"Well, here's another nice mess you've gotten me into."
The Sons of the Desert International Laurel and Hardy Appreciation Society was formed to keep the works of Stan and Ollie before the public and have a good time while doing it. Worldwide, there are well over 100 active chapters today whose members meet regularly to enjoy Laurel and Hardy movies in a casual atmosphere. It turns out Babe Hardy was good friends with golfing buddy and brother Freemason, John Wayne. So when Wayne asked Oliver to co-star with him in The Fighting Kentuckian in 1949, he said yes, but only after making sure it was okay with his partner, Stan Laurel. Hardy delivered a memorable light comedy performance with the Duke. As the team aged, health problems began to crop up.
Well, here's another nice mess you've gotten me into.
Look, it didn't help that both men were heavy smokers. Hal Roach said they were a couple of freight train smokestacks. Oliver Hardy suffered a mild heart attack in May 1954, and he began looking after his health for the first time in his life. He lost more than 150 pounds in a few months, which completely changed his appearance. Unfortunately, his health declined over the next 2 years, suffering several debilitating strokes. Oliver Norvell Hardy finally died on August 7, 1957, at age 65. Today, the Sons of the Desert and other Laurel and Hardy aficionados can still visit Harlem, Georgia, to experience the festival, the museum, and to honor Oliver Hardy. Although the comic duo has passed on, their memories will live on in films as long as an audience wants to laugh. If history can be taught with stories, it can never be forgotten. Please like our video, subscribe to our channel, and ring the bell to stay informed on the latest videos. And don't forget to leave your comments and suggestions below for what markers you want to see next.